Hello everyone, IceCool Tech here. So Apple has just gone ahead and released iPadOS 15.3 to the public. So in this video, we're going to be taking a look to see how the 10.5-inch iPad Pro from 2017 handles this latest release. Now of course, if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe to the channel if you wish to see how this iPad handles future software updates. Alright, so if you've been a viewer for a while, at this point you know what I'm about to say. We're going to start things off with the overall performance. So this iPad has actually been really good with iPadOS 15.3. I've noticed a slight performance gain over previous iPadOS 15 releases, including 15.0, 15.1, and of course 15.2, but I would say the gap is much smaller when going from 0.2 to 0.3 than it is 0.1 or earlier to 15.3. So that's always nice to see. Wow, that's beautiful. So now by this point, if you haven't seen either of my previous iPadOS videos, I'll leave an iCard right here linking you to, at the time of recording, the latest video for iPadOS 15.2. In the animation portion of the videos, I do discuss a stuttering problem, almost kind of like ProMotion not working properly. Basically, this is pretty much fixed in iPadOS 15.3, and I'm actually very happy about this because it was pretty annoying, but most animations in this release are much smoother, not showing any signs of stuttering at all. I will say occasionally on the home screen I will have some stuttering, but it's nowhere near as bad as the previous few iPadOS releases, so I'm really glad to say that that is fixed. Now moving on to RAM management, it is overall the same as iPadOS 15.2. I have noticed no difference. It's not any better, it's not any worse, which it wasn't really bad then either, so I guess that's not a terrible thing, but just want to let you know it is the same. Alright, so unfortunately, as this is an iPad that is currently unjailbroken, I cannot share my maximum battery capacity with you, which I usually do for integrity reasons. However, I can tell you something. Several months ago, I did have Apple Support run a diagnostics to check my battery capacity, and it was at 84% at the time. So we're going to assume that it's gone down, let's say, 2% since then. So it's like 82. It is due for replacement. It's not the highest capacity ever, but that hasn't changed the fact that I have had really good battery life after updating to 15.3. I haven't had this good of battery life since iOS 12. It's been seriously amazing. Now, of course, your experience will vary because there's so many different variables like usage, but I did want to share that awesome news with you guys. At the same time, it gets better because after the indexing process finished, which is basically in layman's terms where the device has to undergo a ton of background processes to adjust to the new firmware after updating, the standby drain was pretty much non-existent with only 5% around there overnight, and that is also the best I've seen in a very long time. So, of course, I'm really happy about this. I do want to warn you, however, that, again, your usage will vary. There's, like I said, so many different variables, such as usage, your capacity, and all that type of stuff. But also the fact that up to 3 days after updating, you may notice some extra CPU usage resulting in reduced performance, some extra battery drain, and unlikely but still possible slight overheating. Now, this is, of course, caused by the indexing process, which, again, only lasts, I would say, at most up to 3 days, usually takes like a day. So overheating, it's the same thing as previous releases. I haven't really noticed much there, so there's not really anything to talk about. I've never really experienced this iPad overheating, so that still hasn't changed. All right, so now that we've pretty much talked about everything we needed to talk about, we need to answer the main question of should you update? Now, this is pretty simple this time around. If you are currently on iPadOS 15, any earlier release, I would absolutely recommend updating because then you'll be getting the improvements in things like battery life and animation speeds, but you'll also be getting the plenty of bug fixes and the security fixes that come with pretty much every new release. In this case, like the Safari data leakage bug. Now, if you don't know what that is, I will leave a link in the description to an article where you can read up on that. Now, if you're on iPadOS 14 or earlier, I would recommend staying there until maybe like iPadOS 15.4 because more bugs will be fixed and it's not perfect yet. If you do need to update for any reason, whether it's an app or something, I would suggest updating because it's probably stable enough now. But again, if you're not in any rush to update, I would recommend waiting a few more releases. All right, everyone, that is all I have for this video. Now, if you do have any questions or you'd just like to say hi, make sure to leave a comment down below. Of course, make sure to follow me on Twitter and Instagram using the link in the description. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.